Hello everyone, for the second lesson, we're going to look at topic 14.3, which is about ions and ionic bonds. So for this topic, there will probably be four lessons in total, talking about what is ions and also how do ions form bonds in order to create a compound. So before we look at ions, there are a couple of things that you need to know. Firstly, you need to know about compounds. Okay, so you already learned this before, but I'm going to recap to you again later. And you're going to need to be able to draw the electronic structure of group 8 elements. And then we're going to look at noble gases, which are basically another name for group 8 elements. And we're going to look at why noble gases are unreactive. So first thing, chemical bonding. Two or more elements can be combined together to form a compound. For example, sodium combines with chlorine to form sodium chloride. Hydrogen combines with oxygen to form water. So these are what we call compounds. Most substances in the world are compounds. However, there are a group of elements that usually do not combine with atoms of other elements. And these are the elements in group 8 or sometimes known as group 0 of the periodic table. So these are the ones that you can find here. Okay. And you can see from the periodic table, these are the members or the elements in group 8. So helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. Group 8 are also known as noble gases. These elements here, they are all gases. The atoms of the noble gases are unreactive. So all the elements, helium, neon, argon, krypton, and xenon, all these elements are unreactive. That means they do not react with other elements at all. They don't form any compounds with other elements. So why are they not reactive? That is because they have what we call a stable electronic structure. That means the electronic structure of these elements are all completely filled. As you can see, helium, it has one shell only, and that one shell is full. So you can only fill in two electrons in the first shell, and that shell is full. Neon has 10 electrons, and you can also see all those 10 electrons completely fill in the first and the second shell. So neon has a full electron shell. Argon has 18 electrons, and it has three shells, and all three shells are full. So it's two electrons in the first shell, eight electrons in the second shell, and another eight electrons in the third shell. So all of them have full electron shells, and this is what we mean by stable. So other atoms that do not have a full electron shell are unstable, and they want to be stable. But they cannot be stable on their own, because their electron shells are not completely filled. So in order to become more stable, atoms usually combine with others to form chemical bonds. So this is sort of like the atoms, they are not stable, they do not want to be alone, and in order for them to be complete, and they want their electron shells to be completely filled. So how do they do that? They do that by forming chemical bonds with other elements. So sort of like marriage, for example. So one person is not complete, so in order for that person to feel complete, that person has to marry another person. So atoms are basically the same way. Atoms, they are incomplete on their own, their electron shells are not filled in completely. So what they do is they ask, or they go to another atom and form bonds with them in order to complete themselves. So how do these atoms form bond? There are two ways. The first way is what we call ionic bonding. This is where the atoms, they give or they take electrons from another atom in order to join together, in order to form bonds and become a compound. The second way is what we call covalent bonding. And this is when two atoms share electrons with each other in order to become a compound. So for this topic here, we're only gonna look at ionic bonding first. Okay, and then covalent bonding is something that we will probably look at next month. So to summarize this lesson, what is a compound? Remember, a compound is when two or more elements join together chemically. Some examples of compounds are water, sodium chloride, carbon dioxide, calcium carbonate, and so on. Group 8 elements are known as group 0 or noble gases, so make sure you remember what they are called. And group 8 elements or noble gases are unreactive, and you need to be able to explain why they are unreactive. That's because if you look at their electron shells or their electronic configuration, they have completely filled in electron shell. And because they are completely filled in, they are complete, they do not need to react with other atoms or other elements, and they do not need to form bonds or join together with other atoms because they are all already full, they are already complete. They don't need anything else. That's why they are unreactive. So next lesson, we're going to look at ions and what are ions, what can they do, and how ions are formed.